Greetings everyone, welcome to the 9th episode of Churches of Wales Season 1. In this series, I take a look at buildings part of the church in Wales and covenanted churches in Wales. In the last episode, I looked at churches around the town of Prestine, where I saw many beautiful buildings in settlements like Pileth, Old Radnor, New Radnor, and more. In this episode, I will be looking at churches to the south of Gladestry, and I will be in South Radnorshire. I am Fabian Musto, and I present you the first season of Churches of Wales. In order to find these churches, I will use the Ordnance Survey map on Geograph as my reference for spotting church symbols, from maps of the 1920s, to maps of the 2010s and 20s. I apologize if some of my pronunciations of these place names are incorrect, since I am not a Welsh speaker. I am at the village and community of Gladestry to begin this episode, where the Offa's Dyke long-distance footpath passes the village. The parish church of St. Mary dates from the 13th century, and the nave and chancel were widened and heightened in the 14th century. The churchyard has a medieval stepped base, presumably from said century, and a war memorial was built on the base in the 20th century, built in memory of the people in the community who gave their lives in the two world wars. The north aisle was added to the building in the 14th century, and there are windows of the perpendicular and decorated Gothic style in the chancel, the former from the 16th century. The lectern in the nave dates from 1922, and the church was restored in 1910 and 1982. Yew tree bank can be seen from the churchyard to the east, and the hill, which is 353 meters high, has great views of the village. The west bell tower of the 13th century can be viewed from the hill, with a brooch spire from the 18th century. The church was Grade 1 listed in September 1962. Placed opposite the Royal Oak Inn is a former Seon Baptist chapel, built in 1842 by the B4594 road. There was an older building on the site, which housed a meeting house for the Loyal Order of Ancient Shepherds. The chapel was Grade 2 listed in September 1962. South of the parish church is a former Wesleyan Methodist chapel, built in 1838 and restored in 1864. This was converted to a private house by 1990. 2.5 miles southwest from Gladestry is St. David Church in Culver, presumably the highest church in Wales at nearly 400 meters high. Built in the 13th century, the south porch is from the 15th century, while the timber bellcote is from the 18th century. The building consists of a nave and chancel, and many wall paintings can be seen inside, uncovered during restoration work in the 1980s. The west end of the nave has a painted royal arms board from 1733, which was altered by Thomas Davis in 1838, who was the churchwarden at the time. The churchyard has many yew trees, and the church was Grade 2 star listed in September 1962. Situated 3 miles west is St. David Parish Church in Glascombe, presumably built on the site of a class foundation from the 6th century AD. The church was founded during the 11th century, and the nave dates from the 13th century. The seven-bay arched brace roof is from the 15th century, and the chancel was constructed later that century. The stained glass in the east end dates from 1924, given by James E. D. Nielsen, and the west vestry screen also dates from 1924. The church was restored in 1891 by Ewan Christian, and the church was Grade 1 listed in September 1962. Two and a half miles southwest is the Church of St. David, situated by the River Adu. This was first built in the 13th century, when the nave was built. The exterior was rendered by George Pace from 1957 to 58. The west end has a plain round tub font from the 12th or 13th century, and the four-bay nave roof has an arch-braced roof from the 15th century. The medieval rood screen presumably dates from said century, and the chancel was added after the 13th century. The church was restored in 1903, and was Grade 2 star listed in May 1962. 100 yards north from that church is the Free Mission, which is housed in a Victorian building from the mid-19th century. This was used as a Methodist mission room from 1908 to 66, which was subsequently converted to a non-denominational mission room. The house, gates and railings were Grade 2 listed in March 2000. 3 miles north is Frank's Bridge, which has an English Baptist church from 1909, replacing a chapel from 1835. The present chapel is in a mixed Italianate and arts and crafts style, and the churchyard is situated south of the building. Placed by the River Aberedw is St. Mary Church, built in 1883. This was built on the site of a medieval church, and the south face of the church was refaced in the mid-2010s. The south end of the nave has a perpendicular Gothic font, as well as some wall monuments from the old church. The building consists of a nave and chancel, and the chancel is undivided from the nave. The church does not have listed status as of 2022. 2 miles southwest is St. Bridget Church in Llansantffraid in Elwell, built from 1894 to 96 to the designs of F.R. Kempson. The church was dedicated to St. Frieda on the OS map of 1900, and the bells in the west bellcote are hung in window recesses. The roof of 9 bays in the nave has the appearance of a 15th century church roof, and the pews reuse some old oak from the old church. The church does not have listed status as of 2022. Placed by the A481 road is a former Calvinistic Methodist chapel, built as a Baptist church in 1861 of the vernacular style. This was restored and enlarged in 1930, and the chapel closed as a place of worship in the 2010s. The chapel, attached house and vestry were Grade 2 listed in March 2000. Here is the parish church of St. Matthew in this village and community, which is tens of yards north from the River Wye, which marks the boundary with the historic counties of Radnorshire and Breconshire. The building was extensively restored by John Norton of London in 1877, and the bell tower and font are the only features of the medieval church of the 15th century, although the former was possibly built at a later date. The church was Grade 2 listed in February 2005. Some 2 miles southeast is the Church of St. Mary, situated in a farm and is also near the River Wye. This was built during the medieval times, and the building was partially restored in 1855. The church was restored in 1891 by E.V. Collier of Carmarthen, and the building consists of a nave and chancel with no division. The church does not have listed status as of 2022. Here is the parish church in the village and community of Aberedw, which was built in the 15th and 16th century. The church was presumably established in the 6th century AD by the patron saint of this church, who settled in Radnorshire at the time. The earliest surviving features of the building is the nave and chancel, built in the 16th century. The west bell tower and north porch were presumably built after the 16th century. The 8-bay arched brace roof in the nave is from the 17th century, and the late medieval rood screen dates from the 15th century. The 2 tiers of balusters are post-medieval, and the molded cornice may be the original rood beam. There is no fenestration in the east end of the chancel. The church was Grade 2 star listed in May 1962. Situated west from the church is the United Reformed Church, part of a house that was licensed as a place of worship in 1837. The building is still in use as a place of worship as of 2022. Those buildings are situated by the River Aberedw, which is where the village takes its name from. There is another church by the River Aberedw which is 2.5 miles northeast from Aberedw, and this is dedicated to a Welsh saint from the 6th century. The church was built in the 13th and 14th century, although the south door and font are the only surviving features from that building. The building consists of a nave and chancel, and there is a painted royal arms above the beam that marks the division of said features. The church was restored in 1960, and was Grade II listed in May 1962. Tens of yards west from the church are the ruins of the Congregational Independent Chapel, built in 1826. The building has been in ruins since the late 20th century. 2 miles northwest is a small church in a rural setting, and this is dedicated to Saint David. This was built in the 13th century or later, and was extended to the east after the 14th century. The east end of the chancel has no fenestration, and there are 2 windows in the building. The south window of 3 lights dates from 1723. The church was restored in 1961 and the west wall rebuilt in 1985, and the church was Grade II listed in May 1962. Half a mile west is the former Primitive Methodist Chapel, first built before 1800 and was probably part of a farmhouse. This was rebuilt in the simple round-headed style in 1861, and the chapel closed as a place of worship during the 20th century. The building is in use as a holiday cottage as of 2022. I am in the village and community of Painscastle, where there is a Baptist chapel by the B4594 road. This was built in 1848 of the simple round-headed style, and there is an imprint of the former south entrance to the building. South of that chapel is the former Congregational Chapel, built in the vernacular style in 1828. The chapel closed as a place of worship in the early 2010s, and was subsequently converted to a private house. Some 2 miles west from Painscastle is St. Peter Church, which is the parish church for that settlement. This was first built in the 14th century, when the nave was built, and the chancel dates from the 15th century. The barrel roof with thin molded ribs dates from that century, and the building was described as ruinous in 1872 by the Reverend Francis Kilvert, who replaced the nave roof and designed many of the fittings after his visit. The church was Grade II star listed in September 1960. A mile south is one of the most remote churches in Powys, which can only be accessed from a public footpath to the southeast. This is St. David Church by Pritchard and Seddon in 1860, built on the site of a medieval church. The building consists of a nave and chancel, and there are 2 wooden benches that dates from the 17th century. There are many trees in the churchyard that are older than the present building, and the church was Grade II listed in March 1995. Placed by the B4594 road is the Herman Congregational Chapel of 1839, which was refitted in the late 19th century. In the late 20th century, the chapel briefly became part of the United Reformed Church, and the building was Grade II listed in March 1995. 2 miles north is the Church of St. Michael in Bringwyn, built in the 13th century. There is a stone pillar that moved inside the church in 1958, since it was in the churchyard south of the chancel. Dr. Nash Williams dates the cross between 600 to 800 AD. The church was restored from 1873 to 77 by William Chick of Hereford, and he preserved the fine chancel roof of the 15th century, which consists of arch-braced trusses and quatrefoil wind braces. The nave roof dates from the Restoration, along with the floor tiles by William Godwin of Herefordshire, England. The bellcote and south porch are situated at the west end of the building, and the porch has an arch-braced roof from the 15th century. There is a coffin lid in the east wall of the porch that might be medieval, and the church was Grade II star listed in September 1960. I am in the village of Newchurch, where the Offa's Dyke path passes by the Church of St. Mary. This church was built from 1856 to 57 on the site of a medieval church, and the monolithic font in the west end of the nave is from the 10th or 11th century. The building consists of a nave and chancel, and there is a choir gallery in the west end that is supported by 2 plaster corbel heads. The church was Grade II listed in January 1995. North of the church is the Ebenezer Calvinist Methodist Chapel, built in 1847 in the vernacular style. This chapel is also by the Offa's Dyke path, and the color of pink was applied to the building during the 2010s. New Church is in the community of Gladestry, along with the settlement 2 miles east of New Church, and this is Michael Church on Arrow, situated in a panhandle with the English county of Herefordshire surrounding it. The church to St. Michael dates from the 13th century, and there is a saddleback roof on the west bell tower. The building consists of a nave and chancel, with no fenestration in the east end of the chancel, despite there are windows in the north and south walls with stained glass from the late 19th century. The roof over the sanctuary has 4 carved headbosses on molded ribs, and they depict a grotesque face, Joan of Navarre, Henry IV and a Bishop of Hereford. These date from around 1412, and the boards date from the 19th century. The chancel screen dates from the 15th century, restored by Thomas Nicholson in the mid-19th century. He restored the church in 1869, and the building was Grade 1 listed in September 1962. In the community of Clyro is a remote chapel of ease to Clyro Parish Church, and this is the Church of the Holy Trinity, built from 1878 to 79 by F.R. Kempson of Hereford. This was built on the site of a medieval church, and the interior has remnants of a roof, structure and rood loft from the 15th century. The building was Grade 2 star listed in January 1995. The next chapel is also in the community of Clyro, built as a timber-framed structure in the 16th century. This was partly rebuilt in stone in the 18th century, and the uphill end of the structure was converted into a Baptist chapel in 1844. The building was Grade 2 listed in January 1995. Here is the parish church of St. Michael in Clyro, built in the decorated Gothic style in 1853 by Thomas Nicholson of Hereford. Built on the site of a medieval church, Nicholson retained the 2 lower stages of the West Bell Tower from the 14th century. The Reverend Francis Kilvert was curate of this church from 1865 to 72, where he referenced the church in his diaries reflecting rural life. The church was Grade 2 star listed in January 1995, and northwest is the Congregational Chapel, built of the simple Gothic style in 1890. The chapel was converted to a private house during the 2010s. Placed by the A438 road is the parish church in this settlement, which is dedicated to an abbot and confessor that lived in the 7th century AD. The church has a cross slab in the west end of the nave, dating from the 11th century. This was set up in the churchyard during the 12th century, but was moved inside the church in 1956. Also placed in the west end is the font of the 13th century, which was placed back in the church in 1955 after it was in the garden of this local crook-framed hall house for some time. The church was largely rebuilt by W.J. and A.H. Worthington of London from 1853 to 55, and they preserved little of the medieval church structure. The lower stage of the West Bell Tower dates from the 13th or 14th century, and the church was Grade 2 listed in January 1996. This rural Seon Methodist chapel is northwest from the previous settlement, and this was first built in 1816 and rebuilt in 1846. The stone structure closed as a place of worship in the late 20th century, and was Grade 2 listed in January 1996. Situated south is the United Reformed Chapel, where nonconformist meetings were first held here with the beginning of Vavasor Powell's ministry in 1640. The independent chapel here originated from the 1649 Act for the Better Propagation and Preaching of the Gospel in Wales, and various ministers have been recorded here from the 1650s. The chapel and adjoining cottage were built in the vernacular style in 1696, and there are many wall monuments inside that show the history of nonconformity in the area. The chapel and adjoining cottage were Grade 1 listed in September 1960. The Congregational Chapel at Glasbury was established in 1682, but the building behind me was built by Thomas Thomas in 1866 of the Gothic style. The chapel closed as a place of worship during the late 20th century, and was renovated in the late 2000s. The building is now known as Chapel on the Green, which houses a creative accommodation, retreat center and artistic space, and was Grade 2 listed in January 1996. A mile northwest from Glasbury is All Saints Church, built from 1881 to 82 by George Cowley Haddon, in memory of Walter de Winton, who lived at the country house north of the church. The church is by the south entrance drive to that country house, and the church does not have listed status as of 2022. Southwest from the church is the Wesleyan Methodist Church, built in 1818 in the simple Gothic style. The chapel was Grade 2 listed in January 1996. Situated east of the River Wye is this village church, built by C.H. Howell in 1870 to replace a medieval church. The church is dedicated to Saint Kinog, and the spire on the north bell tower was reduced in height in 1988 to reduce maintenance costs, but a new spire was constructed in 2004. The church was Grade 2 listed in January 1996. Northwest from that village is a closed Primitive Methodist chapel, built in 1829 and rebuilt in 1864 in the simple round-headed style. These photographs from 2011 show the chapel in a dilapidated state, but has been renovated to a private house since. Here is the Church of St. Stephen in this settlement, dating from the 12th or 13th century when the nave was first built. The West Bell Tower is presumably from the 14th century, but was mainly rebuilt in the 16th century. The chancel was built in the 14th century, and the church was restored by Thomas Nicholson from 1867 to 69. This was Grade 2 listed in September 1960. Placed by the B4594 road is the Moriah Baptist Chapel, built in 1834 and rebuilt in 1884. Some 2 miles west is the last building I will look at in this episode, and this is the village church that is dedicated to this Welsh saint from the 6th century. The nave was presumably built in the 14th century, and the chancel dates from the 15th century. The south porch may be from the 16th century, and Sir John Betjeman described the interior as magnificently simple. The church retains most of its medieval fabric, and E.V. Collier restored the building in 1897, when he rebuilt most of the west tower. There are 3 male yew trees situated on the south side of the church, and the church was Grade 2 star listed in September 1960. I am at the west entrance of the church to end this episode. I enjoyed looking at religious buildings in South Radnorshire, and I will continue looking at them in the next episode as I head north to Clandron, Dodwells and Rader.